So sad. My parents were my friends, you know. I had a good rapport with them. And then we were kicking just good. Until this COVID stuff took them from us. But we give thanks to the Most High. May their souls rest in perfect peace. We love you and we always remember you. Dwumfour, Mom and Dad, one love.
Dad, I miss you. I love you and I will never forget you. It really doesn't feel real that you're gone. But I trust God and I know that you're in a better place. I wish if I had known that the last time I spoke to you would be the last time, I would have lingered on the phone a little longer. I would have taken in your voice one more time and let it swirl around my mind. You were a great, great man, a kind man, a loving father, I still remember as a little girl you picking me up in your blue Volvo and taking me to McDonald's after school. These memories that we have, I will cherish in my heart forever. And while we don't understand why you couldn't stay on earth longer with us, we trust God and we know that where you are, you're at peace. And so I thank God for that. I thank Auntie Marian for being there with you in the last years of your life to share, to care for you, to care for one another. And I pray that you're flying high with the angels together. Dad.
I cried endlessly like a baby when you passed away. I was deeply saddened and sincerely shocked when the news broke, one and then the other. I was quickly taken aback into times when you would tell me to endeavor to remain strong at all times, as if you knew I would need two times the strength to bear this relentless pain, as if you knew that death would deal me the blow twice in a short period. To honor your memory, I won't despair, but rather keep strong as time passes, because both of you taught me to be a strong-willed individual. They say parents' hearts are the classroom for their children, and indeed so were yours. No one can ever fill the void that the departure has created in my life. Your place in my heart will always remain sacred. I can never forget the great times, the not so good moments, the joys and the tears we went through together whilst you were around. You sacrificed a lot for my sake, and it upset me that I could not reciprocate your loving gestures in order to show my appreciation of the number one couple in my world. Father, there have been countless occasions after your departure, Daddy Joe, when I lacked the desire and strength to move on, but I would hear your voice in an unseen God, and how to have faith in an unseen God. You guided me until I could stand firmly and believe on my own. Those favorite lines of yours, respect yourself and always be close to God, have become a mantra that I consistently recite to baby Marian, so that her soul will trap its power and grow into the mother and woman that you were. Reflecting on how you would hide your grief and console others, I can imagine that if you were sitting here on this occasion, you would smile at me and tell me how good my clothes look on me, and end up in the back with your lady trying to cheer them up until the event is over and everybody has to leave. You both raised me as a Christian. You all taught me that death only separates physically. I grew in faith, and I'm certain that you are resting in the blessed bosom of the Father, waiting to be reconciled with us one day. You fought a good fight. You won the proverbial race, and know for sure that you will wear your crowns of righteousness, which the Lord Himself bestows upon its faithful servants. Thank you.
Strength, a very present help in trouble. I know that my Redeemer lives, and that at last he will stand upon the earth. And after my skin has been destroyed, then in my flesh I shall see God, whom I shall see for myself, and my eyes shall behold, not another. Steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His mercies never come to an end. They're new every morning. Great is his faithfulness. Out of the depths I have cried to you, O Lord. Lord, hear my voice. Let your ears consider well the voice of my supplications. Blessed are those who mourn, for they shall be comforted. Out of the depths have I cried to you, Lord. Lord, hear my voice. Let your ears consider well the voice of my supplication. The Lord be with you, my brothers and sisters. We meet in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, the one who died and was raised to the glory of God the Father. May his grace and his mercy be with you all. Can I please say that we have an order of service kindly provided by the family, and I would ask that we consult that where we're going to run the service for. Some of us have parts to play in the service. Please, I would ask that kindly step forward. Okay, this is so that you can use the lectern as best you can. But please, we have limited time, and I will be very grateful if you respected that time limit. Thank you so much. We will go from here after this. Of course, we have to go and bury the body of our brother, Uncle Joe. And so please be mindful that we will have to go work on that journey down to the grave side as well. So is that a moment of quiet? We have a difficult task. And the grace of God is more than sufficient. We have come here this morning to remember before God our sister Marian, and our brother Joe. We will give thanks for their lives. We will commend them to Almighty God, who is a merciful Redeemer and our judge. We will commit Marian's body to be cremated in this place, and from here we will go to bury Joe's body. But most of all, chief of all, we are here to comfort one another. We extend the same sentiments to those who are watching us from afar, whether in America, Ghana, Ireland, or elsewhere on these shores. Let's begin with a time of prayer. Heavenly Father, you have made us for darkness and death. You have not made us for darkness and death, but for life with you forever. Without you, we have nothing to hope for. But with you, we have nothing to fear. So Lord, speak to us now. Speak your words of eternal life. Lift us up from anxiety and guilt to the light and peace of your presence. And set the glory of your love ever before us. We ask this through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Just remain standing.
Biography of the late Marian Philippa Ben-Acquaah. Marian Philippa Ben-Acquaah, Irama Akaba, the only female child amongst five siblings, was born on 3rd February 1951 to Reverend Father Justice William Ben-Acquaah of the Anglican Church of Ghana and Mrs. Charlotte Ben-Acquaah, Nay Tichimenson, a teacher, both of blessed memory. She spent her early childhood days in Cape Coast. She started schooling at St. Monica's Primary School, Cape Coast, continued at the Anglican Primary School in Kumasi. She attended St. Monica's Girls' School, Ashanti Mampong, for her middle schooling and had her secondary education at Oda Secondary School, Akim Oda, in the Eastern Region. Marian later enrolled at Sight and Sound Secretarial Institute in Accra. She worked for a while as a secretary with a weekly Palava newspaper, managed at the time by the late versatile journalist Chris Asher. She in fact won the maiden Miss Palava Beauty competition organized by the same newspaper in the 1970s. After working for some time with a newspaper publisher, she resigned her position to go into private business, which took her to Europe and America. She finally settled in the UK with her long-term partner, the late Commander retired Joseph Essiedu, also being laid to rest today, father of her two children, Joseph Jr. and Carlton Essiedu. Being orphaned at very early ages, Sister Irama, as she was affectionately called, became mother especially to her two surviving siblings till her last day. Irama was unapologetically Anglican and served with merit in various roles in different locations from Kumasi to Tema. She was a member of the brigade at St. Cyprian Anglican Church, Fanti Newtown, Kumasi, where her late father ministered. She was for a long time a member of St. Alban Anglican Church, Tema, where she served in various capacities as a member of the choir, president of St. Mary's Guild, as well as a member of the Harvest Committee Board. In the UK, she was a member of the Holy Trinity Anglican Church Choir in Tottenham. She was loved by all who related to her due to her passion for service and caregiving. She was willing to share with others the little she had so everyone got something. We are saddened that she passed on 8 days from her 70th birthday. But our Lord, who knows the end from the beginning, decided her work in the garden is done and gave her a higher calling on the 27th of January, 2021. The void created by her passing will be a difficult one to fill, but God will continue to be our tower of strength. Our real tribute is to continue her good works while being mindful to avoid the mistakes she made. We pray that she rests peacefully in the bosom of our Heavenly Father. Fare thee well, Marian. Nyankopono fomo krensi. Demi fadi.
Tribute to Mommy from children, Joseph and Carlton. A woman of substance is what we called her. A dependable woman who had respect for both young and old. A loving and caring mother who shared her little, the little that she had equally to satisfy humanity. Always gave even when it has left with her last penny. She didn't mind giving it out to who needed it the most, just to make sure that that person was okay. A precious and exquisite mother, always ready to serve God at all times, whether good or bad. Mommy always wanted us united and happy because she always said, we have to be one no matter what, just like Daddy. She always implored us to live as one family, being each other's keeper. Mommy was a fantastic homemaker. She provided for us and never let us lack anything. Mommy loved to cook and always prepared delicious meals. Companies who ordered her food always commended her for the tasty meals. She was always at the forefront of organizing social activities. She enjoyed planning and organizing programs for both kids and adults. Example, St. Mary's Guild, Children of St. Mary's, St. Alban Anglican Church, picnics, St. Monica's Old Girls, the community she lived in, Tema, to mention Community 3, Community 5, and Community 8 in Ghana. Mommy traveled to the UK but remained the same, the great cook and event organizer. People who came into contact with her in the UK attest to this, because she did all the things she loved just the same as she used to do. All those will be greatly missed. It was a blow on that fateful day of 27 July 2027, a few weeks into the new year, to lose our beloved mother, our solid rock. We had video calls in the days prior to this tragic day. Mommy was consoling us when we were down with a lot of jokes to make us smile and laugh out loud. Never did she look like she was going to leave us so soon. She was very active, but only God knows why. Ben-Acquaah is truly the queen of our hearts. There's no other like you. We do appreciate your love and kindness. Kudos, Mom. Rest in the peaceful abode of the God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. We will love and always remember you until the end of time. Then refer to you, Mommy, to you. Amen.
Biography of Commander Retired Joseph Essuman Essiedu. Commander Retired Joseph Essuman, affectionately called Joe Essiedu, was born on March 1st, 1943 at Kolibu Teaching Hospital in Accra, to the late Chief Superintendent of Police, John Emmanuel Essiedu of Katechiasi, Fantinyankumase in the Central Region of Ghana, and the late Mrs. Margaret Amanbofuah Essiedu, named Amanbofuah Amakohene of Asindwabi, also in the Central Region. He attended the Arakan Barracks Primary and Middle School in Bemakam, Accra, from 1948 to 1958, and passed its common entrance examination in 1958, and was accepted to do his secondary education at St. Augustine's College in Cape Coast. He was a member of the college's 1961-63 athletic team, where he took part in the long jumps, high jumps, triple jump events for the school. He was a member of St. Augustine's College after cadet corps. After the completion of secondary school in 1963, he enlisted in the Navy and trained at the Officers Training School at Teshi in Greater Accra. After the training, he was sent to Naval Training Academy in Dublin, Ireland. He returned to Ghana in 1965 as sub-lieutenant of the Ghana Navy and worked at the Naval Eastern Command in Tema. After being promoted to Naval Commander in 1968, he was transferred to Western Naval Command in Takoradi in the Western Region of Ghana, where he served as one of the commandants in the commandership. He was promoted to lieutenant commander in 1973. From 1974 to 1976, he was transferred to Accra, where he worked in the state house, Osu Castle, under the late General Ignatius Kutu Achampong, the then head of state and chairman of the Supreme Military Council. From 1977 to 78, he attended the United States Senior Naval College in Annapolis, Maryland. He was then promoted to naval commander in 1978 and sent to the naval headquarters of the Chief of Naval Administration. In October 1979, after commanding a military parade of the Ghana Armed Forces at the inauguration of the Third Republic of Ghana, His Excellency, the then President of the Republic of Ghana, the late Dr. Hila Liman, appointed Commander Joe Essiedu as his aide-de-camp, where he toured with the President to India and Europe. He served the President diligently until the overthrow of the Third Republic on 31st December 1981. He then reverted to his role as the naval commander as the Chief of Naval Administration under the until he retired from the Ghana Armed Forces in 1982. He went to the United States in 1984 and lived there until his death on 10th of February 2021, 2 weeks after the death of his dear wife, Madam Marian Ben-Acquaah. Amen.
Tribute to Daddy from children. On behalf of Sonia Essiedu in Ireland, Pamela Essiedu also in Ireland, Ben-Acquaah Chi Essiedu in Accra, Carlton Essiedu, Accra, Yvonne Essiedu Amankwa in Atlanta, Georgia, and Josephine Essiedu in Dubai. A retired naval officer and a gentleman. Daddy was a respectable and distinguished naval officer. His colleagues who served with him during the time of the late Dr. Hila Liman, former president of the Republic of Ghana, can attest to that. Commander, retired Joseph Essuman Essiedu, Daddy Joe, the love and attention you showed in your lifetime made us feel the one thing you always said. I'm so proud to have you guys as my children. It gives us the strength and hope to persevere in all walks of life. Honestly, you are a very special father and will always have a place in our hearts. We know your biggest wish was to see us, your sons and daughters, live in peace, love, and unity as one family, so that our generation becomes perfect. We can assure you that we won't fail, Daddy. Sometimes it's hard to believe our good shepherd, who was always there for us, is gone. Our hearts are broken. Daddy, you are the friend we could share our secrets with and sometimes laugh over issues with. Who are we going to turn to now that you are gone? We will dearly miss your timely advice. It always came at the right time. You always said this: I love you and pray that you get the best out of all your endeavors. We know you wish the best for us, and we will forever cherish that. we will forever love you and always remember you as a very good father. Thank you for always being kind, non-judgmental, and always showing us love. We will miss talking to you on weekends and your advice to your grandchildren to be good to mom and dad always. May the good God be with you. Rest in perfect peace, Daddy. In my world, the Marie for joy.
Thank you, each and every one of you, for your words and tribute to Uncle Joe and Auntie Marie. You know, count the fact, acknowledge the fact that we are still here at the foot of the cross, a place that was much cherished by Auntie Marie and Uncle Joe. And we are going to reconcile ourselves both with God and with our two dear departed. So we ask God for forgiveness for our sins and indeed to narrow, to close the gaps that may have existed between us and them. So as children of a loving Heavenly Father, let us ask God for his forgiveness, for his gentle and full of compassion. We'll bow our heads, please. God of mercy, we acknowledge that we all are sinners. We turn from the wrong that we have thought and said and done. We are mindful of all that we have failed to do, especially all that we have left amiss in our relationships with our dear departed ones. For the sake of Jesus who died for us, forgive us all for all that is past. Help us to live each day in the light of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Let's receive God's assurance of forgiveness. May God, our Father, forgive us our sins and bring us to the eternal joy of his kingdom, where dust and ashes have no dominion. Amen.
Amen.
Now for the gathering prayer of collect and funerals. Merciful Father, hear our prayers and comfort us. Renew our trust in your Son, whom you raised from the dead. Strengthen our faith that all who have died in the love of Jesus Christ will come to share in his resurrection, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forevermore. Amen. Just let us pay careful attention to the readings of God's Holy Word.
Reading from the book of Lamentations, chapter 3. The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His mercies never come to an end. They are new every morning. Great is your faithfulness. The Lord is my portion, says my soul. Therefore, I will hope in him. The Lord is good to those who wait for him, to the soul that seeks him. It is good that one should wait quietly for the salvation of the Lord. For the Lord will not reject forever. Although he causes grief, he will have compassion according to the abundance of his steadfast love. For he does not willingly afflict or grieve anyone. This is the word of the Lord.
A reading from John, chapter 14, verse 1 to 6. A reading from the Gospel of John. Jesus, the way to the Father, Do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me. In my Father's house there were many dwelling places. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may be also. And you know the way to the place where I am going. Thomas said to him, Lord, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way? Jesus said to him, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. This is the word of the Lord.
May I speak in the name of God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit. The gospel reading, which we have just had, gives us the consoling words that Jesus Christ addressed to his own disciples. And they are now addressed to us gathered here, that virtually or present at this funeral. Don't let your heads drop down. Don't let your hearts be troubled. Do not be discouraged. Do not be discouraged. Do not let your heart droop. Do not despair. This is the heart of the Christian message. Take heart, be bold, for the Lord your God is with you. That is what is at the heart of the Christian message. And it is the reason why we gather here this morning, where we gather as representatives of the community of faith, of love, of service, and of the bonds of family and blood that we share with this couple, Uncle Joe and Auntie Marie. It is the reason why we have taken the trouble, even though it's been so many months since they've died, to ensure that we bury them in the memory of our Lord Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, who was also their Lord and their Savior. Now, the death of one person, especially their parents, can be a great blow. Perhaps a friend, you might say, well, you may very well have other friends. But a parent, and then parents, that is a great blow. But whatever our relationship to this couple, we have tasted in its raw form that bereavement, pain, is the price of love. We have greatly missed them. We will continue to miss them greatly, sorely. And it's because we love them. We love them, not because they were perfect, but because they treasured us. They offered their love to us. Not because they were rich, but because they just felt it was important that we felt better in their company. Time like this, we all need a great deal of love and of kindness. We all need a great deal of concern and a rallying round of each other. The first thing I want to say is we thank God for the way in which family and friends have rallied around together to present this occasion. Almighty God bless each and every one of us Now, Jesus Christ said, don't be discouraged. Don't let your hearts be troubled. My Father's house has many rooms. If it weren't so, I would not have told you. What strange words. What strange words for us to be comforted with by the absence. How do they equate? How do they compensate for the wonderful memories of the life of service that are represented here? One at a time in his life of public service to his nation, an officer in the service of his president and his country. And another lady, one time a secretary, but at all times a person of the faith, of the rosary, of the Jews of the faith. Auntie Marian, who I knew as a pastor, as our priest, chief of all, as a friend, someone whom we all know very well to have been, somebody who gave her life and devoted all that she had to our church here as we treat you. And it is heartening to see and to read that indeed all that she represented to us, she has steadfastly been to people in the churches where she has connections. So we thank God for their faith, for their service. Still, what Jesus says to us is that there are many rooms in my Father's house. If it weren't so, I wouldn't tell you. Why is this a poor offer? Why is it an adequate offer? Because we are bound to ask first, is it a poor offer? Is it an adequate offer? Until we look at it very closely and we look at it and say that, well, yes, if you are blessed with a house of many rooms, imagine the extended opportunities that you are given to make use of that space, to make use of each room. Or would you hoard it to yourself? Or would you keep them to yourself? No. And what Jesus is hinting us is that death is an opportunity for us to extend beyond the narrow ways in which we've known this couple, all that they mean to us. And I ask that Almighty God, bless us with that same endeavor in our own lives. We are burying Auntie Marian and Uncle Joe a week ago from Ascension Day. Again, the time when the disciples of Jesus had to confront the absence of their Lord and their Master. And just as before his death, what he does is that simply says, just be patient. Be encouraged. Wait. God's gift of the Holy Spirit is coming. And we know this Sunday we will celebrate the gift of that Holy Spirit, the founding of the church to which Auntie Marian devoted her life. And what is the church except to say that this is the hand, the feet, the body, the eyes, the very extension of our Lord Jesus Christ, which I can say very boldly, Auntie Marian was. So thank you for gifting us this funeral on this particular season, that liminal, that transition space between when we know that God does not fail on his promises, that he is the way, the truth, and the life for us. We can be sure that the Holy Spirit will attend to all those whom you left behind and to us for one purpose, so that we too can live the life of service that you lived. We pray that Almighty God will breathe into all that you have left behind the treasury of love, the treasury of service, to the choir, to the Sunday school, to all the many groups of women at our church, and to all the many services that you held for us in your personal capacity as our chef, as our organizer at events, and as friend to each and every one of us. And I always want to say thank God for all of you. The telephone calls, the way in which you will come and stand erect in our services as a sort of encouragement. May God Almighty bless each and every one of those whom you left behind. May Almighty God grant the Holy Spirit to energize them to live true to the treasury of love that you represent. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us pray. To the bidding, Lord, in your mercy, please respond, hear our prayer. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
God of mercy and God of life, and the God who created us in your image to reflect your truth and your light. We give thanks, Lord, for you, for all that you represented of yourself, Uncle Joe and Auntie Mary, for the grace and the mercy that they received from you, for all that was good in them, in their lives, and for all the memories that we treasure of them this day. Especially, Lord, we thank you for whom they were amongst us, vessels of your love, means and agents of service. Lord, in your mercy, Heavenly Father, you promised eternal life to those who believe. Now remember for good these your servants, as we also remember them. Bring them along with all who rest in the Lord into the fullness of your kingdom, where sins have been forgiven and death is no more. Lord, in your mercy, Father, your mighty power brings joy out of life, and life out of death. Look in your mercy on all who mourn, pray especially for the children. Pray for family and friends, near and far. Grant us all patient faith in times of darkness. Strengthen us in the knowledge of your love. Lord, in your mercy, you are tender towards your children. Your mercy is ever all yours. Now heal the memories of us and Philip. Give each and every one of us here present the wisdom and the grace to use aright the time that is left for us here and now. Appoint us, Lord, to the rooms of service that you have opened up for us in the wake of their life, and help us to follow in the footsteps of Jesus Christ into the way that leads us to everlasting life. Lord, in your mercy, trust in all that you have made, and rejoice in our communion with all God's faithful people. Let us now see together the family prayer that our Savior taught.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, and will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever.
Can I ask us all to please? Son Jesus Christ conquered death, entered into glory. Confident of his victory and claiming his promises, you now entrust them to your mercy. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord, who died, is alive, and reigns with you, now and forever.
Amen.
Lord, our God is full of compassion and mercy. He is slow to anger and of great goodness. As a father is tender towards his children, so is the Lord tender to all those that fear him. For he knows that we are made of dust and remembers that that is what we are. For our days are like the grass, flourish like a flower of the field. When the wind goes over it, it is gone, and its place knows it no more. For the merciful goodness of the Lord endures forever and ever towards all those that fear him, and his righteousness rests upon their children's children. Brothers and sisters, God entrusted our sister, Marian, Philippa, Ben-Acquaah, child of God, sinner of his own making. And we now commit our body to be cremated, heart to heart, ashes to ashes, and dust to dust. A sure and certain hope of the resurrection to eternal life, through our Lord Jesus Christ, who will transform our frail bodies so that they may be conformed to his own glorious body, the one who died, was buried, and rose again for us. To him be glory forever and ever.
Amen.
Yes. Yeah, check. Thank you. brought nothing into the world, and we take nothing out. The Lord gave, and the Lord has now taken away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Jesus said, truly I tell you, today you will be with me in paradise. Ashes dust to dust. We show a certain hope of the resurrection to eternal life through our Lord Jesus Christ, who died, was buried, and rose again for us. To him be glory forever and ever. Amen.
Especially give to Opapawahao. And then Uncle Joe say, I love you so much, daughter. Those are all the fond memories we have of you. God keep you. Amen.
Amen.
Yeah. So sad. So sad. My parents were my friends, you know. I had a good rapport with them. And then we were kicking just good. Until this COVID stuff took them from us. But we give thanks to the Most High. May their souls rest in perfect peace. We love you. And we always remember you. Demifati, Mom and Dad, one love.
Dad, I miss you. I love you. And I will never forget you. It really doesn't feel real that you're gone. But I trust God and I know that you're in a better place. I wish if I had known that the last time I spoke to you would be the last time, I would have lingered on the phone a little longer. I would have taken in your voice one more time and let it swirl around my mind. You were a great, great man, a kind man, a loving father, I still remember as a little girl you picking me up in your blue Volvo and taking me to McDonald's after school. These memories that we have, I will cherish in my heart forever. And while we don't understand why you couldn't stay on earth longer with us, we trust God and we know that where you are, you're at peace. And so I thank God for that. I thank Auntie Marian for being there with you in the last years of your life to share, to care for you, to care for one another. And I pray that you're flying high with the angels together. Dad, always stay close to us. You will always be in my heart.
And I cried endlessly like a baby when you passed away. I was deeply saddened and sincerely shocked when the news broke, one and then the other. I was quickly taken aback into times when you would tell me to endeavor to remain strong at all times, as if you knew I would need two times the strength to bear this relentless pain, as if you knew that death will deal me the blow twice in a short period. To honor your memory, I won't despair, but rather keep strong as time passes, because both of you taught me to be a strong-willed individual. They say parents' hearts are the classroom for their children, and indeed so were yours. No one can ever fill the void that you, the departure has created in my life. Your place in my heart will always remain sacred. I can never forget the great times, the not so good moments, the joys and the tears we went through together whilst you were around. You sacrificed a lot for my sake, and it upsets me that I could not reciprocate your loving gestures in order to show my appreciation of the number one couple in my world. Father, there have been countless occasions after your departure, Daddy Joe, when I lacked the desire and strength to move on, but I would hear your voice in an unseen God, and how to have faith in an unseen God. You guided me until I could stand firmly and believe on my own. Those favorite lines of yours, respect yourself and always be close to God, have become a mantra that I consistently recite to baby Marian, so that her soul will trap its power and grow into the mother and woman that you were. Reflecting on how you would hide your grief and console others, I can imagine that if you were sitting here on this occasion, you would smile at me and tell me how good my clothes look on me and end up in the back with your lady trying to cheer them up until the event is over and everybody has to leave. You both raised me as a Christian. You all taught me that death only separates physically. I grew in faith, and I'm certain that you are resting in the blessed bosom of the Father, waiting to be reconciled with us one day. You fought a good fight. You won the proverbial race, and know for sure that you will wear your crowns of righteousness, which the Lord Himself bestows upon its faithful servants.
Thank you. no, 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 no,